Hi and welcome. I'm excited to share this air dry clay project with you today. I will go through the basics so it's perfect for beginners and pick up some air dry clay tips and tricks along the way. Air dry clay straight out of the packet should be lovely and soft just like this. I like to form it and slap it into a ball just like this and then smooth out any of those creases. When it comes to rolling and sculpting the clay, this makes sure that there's less cracks appear along the way. The clay is now lovely and smooth, and this didn't take very long at all. So now I can take my rolling pin and roll out the desired thickness. My method for rolling out is to roll and turn and roll and turn. This tip just ensures that the clay does not get stuck to the surface. My clay is lovely and smooth, and that's mainly because we started with that really smooth ball of clay to begin with. To smooth out any imperfections, we can add a little bit of water to our fingers and rub over as I did then. And then I always like to turn the piece over and make sure that the underside is also lovely and smooth. I used an old table knife to smooth out the cracks on the underside and then smooth with my fingers. And now I'm taking the table knife and cutting a shape. And you can cut absolutely any shape you wish. Use a template if you need to. Or if you have some cookie cutters, you could use those as well. Taking a slightly damp finger, I've smoothed around the edges. And to give my dish its shape, I'm using this bowl that is waxed or varnished, so it's got a nice smooth surface. This will help to prevent the clay sticking to the bowl, but I am going to remove the clay out of the bowl before it's fully dry. You can see I just used my fingers to add some curves into the clay. I removed the air-dry clay out of the wooden bowl after about 24 hours. Then set it on my smooth tile to dry fully, and that gave it the flat base. The clay is now fully dry, and there we saw some crease lines in the clay, and so we can take some really fine sandpaper and we can smooth any imperfections out of the clay. Or of course leave it rustic. If you are sanding, I recommend doing this outside, but I've taken this outside to remove all the dust, so I recommend wearing a mask and not breathing in those particles. Next, I will show you how I paint the air-dry clay with acrylic paints. I like to give the whole surface of the dried air-dry clay one full coat of acrylic paint. You could use something like a gesso or an undercoat, but I find if you use your acrylic paints and then use a good top coat, that makes it a really good finish. I have a large, soft acrylic paintbrush here, and the acrylic paint goes on really well. Mix together enough of your acrylic paint colour so that you can do at least two coats over the whole piece. My idea here is to paint all but the flat base, so you can see I'm choosing an area to hold onto and then I'm leaving that flat base free. I'm doing this because I want to try and paint as much of the piece in one go as I can, but if you are not in as much of a rush as me, just paint this top side, wait for it to dry, and then you can turn it over and paint the rest. But as you can see here, I get majority of the first coat on in one go. While the dish is drying, we want to save the rest of our mixed paint, and so I put that in a little tub and turn it over like this. This is going to be a floral dish, so what I recommend is have a search around on the internet or in some books and draw out some little designs, put a little bit of a mixture together, a bit of a mood board on your paper there, and then go from there. You can plan it out exactly how you're going to do it and paint a piece of paper or in your sketch pad exactly how you're going to do it first, or as I'm going to do here, just make it up as I go along. One thing that is important to me though is getting a colour palette that I really love, so this is what I've done on that little piece of paper there. When laying out a design on a piece like this, I tend to go in with the larger of the shapes or designs first, and that way it gives you space to work those in. I gave this dish a second coat of paint, and so the orange there has gone on really well in just two coats. The pink paint is going on reasonably well, but it will need another coat as well. So you let this dry in between coats and then go back in with your colour once again. Using a really fine paintbrush, I'm painting in the leaves. That way I can get a really nice tip on each end of the leaf. This green is really strong in pigment, and I think it will only need one coat of this green. As you're working along between colours, it's really important to wash the acrylic paint out of the brushes. I always have an old rag on hand to help me with this and make sure I absorb all of the water back out of the paintbrush so that we're not watering down that acrylic paint. If you water down the acrylic paint at this stage for your bolder items, it's only going to take so many more coats of paint. My handy little pot that is upside down here still has a tiny bit of remaining orange paint in, so I can add a little bit of white paint to this and use this as another colour for my colour palette. Keep doing this and getting some nice blends of colour for your lovely colour palette. I always think when we get to this stage of painting the pieces that I really forget they're actually air dry clay. And how amazing is that? We can make this whole project from start to finish. Do you notice that as I paint items like this, I'm keeping part of my hand steady on the side of the dish, just gently to steady that brush? Or like here, I'm using my other hand to steady my working hand. Use the shape of your brush to help you with petal shapes like this. And if you also notice, I hold the dish up and I move the dish around depending on where I'm painting. This just makes your life a lot easier. Just make sure you're not putting your fingers into the wet paint. Sculpting air dry clay and then being able to paint it, I find the whole process really therapeutic. So I do hope you have a go at some of my projects over here and that you can also relax and enjoy the process. Let's not really worry about the finished results at this stage. Just practice and lots more practice until you get to the results you desire. Before adding that blue leaf in, I really should have added the stems of these other flowers, so I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of those in before I put any more blue flowers in. It's sometimes good to plan just that little bit or completely ad lib, it's completely up to you. When I first set out to complete this project, I decided I was going to completely cover the whole of the dish in all these lovely florals, but now that I have it like this, I'm actually really quite liking the simplicity of these bold shapes, but I'm going to keep going and showing you how I add lots more of the florals to give a full floral pattern. When doing some thinner lines like this, I do have a really fine paintbrush, but also at this stage you can add just that tiny little bit of water to help the thin of the paintbrush really flow and give you that crisp line. So I find at this stage it is okay to add that little bit of water to the acrylic paint. These lines do need to go over with a second coat of paint though to just make sure they are bold enough. Acrylic paint, we are quite lucky that it does really dry quickly, but do just make sure you're not going over areas and smudging anything as you go, so you can leave each colour to dry in between. So it does take quite a bit of time to complete a project like this, but as I said, relax and enjoy the process. My design is starting to come together and the spaces are gradually getting filled. This bigger space here needs filling next, so I'm going to add another flower. I'm heading straight in with the yellow acrylic paint, but what I do recommend with lighter colours like this is to maybe put a white underneath, and then one layer or two layers of the yellow paint work better. It's just when you see here the yellow doesn't stand out very deep, but that's okay in this project, but with other colours and with other projects you might like the yellow to really stand out, and so a way to do that is to put a white layer down first and then paint the yellow over the top. You can practice painting any of these shapes on your paper first. If you're not so used to painting fine detail with a paintbrush, as it can be a little tricky and it does take a little practice. All my creative videos here on YouTube are to purely inspire you and to give you some ideas. If you are a beginner, maybe start with a smaller piece, a small trinket dish or a coaster. And you can see a similar project where I painted a trinket pot in a lovely little design. That didn't take too long to paint, and so you could try something like this too. There's always other ways to create a design as well without having to be able to paint, and so you can add dots to a project. You can use the other end of a paintbrush or a pencil or a pen and create dots just like this. And look how beautiful this other air dry clay vase turned out over on another of my videos. I really love to add spots to pieces like this, and it's really easy with acrylic paint. Keep building up a design as much or as little as you wish. What kinds of things would you like to paint on a dish like this, or what kind of colour palette would you use? Please comment in the comments section below this video. Also, if you've not subscribed yet, please do press the subscribe button and the bell button so that you'll be notified for all my latest videos. White wasn't necessarily in my colour palette, but I just felt at this stage we needed something that little bit brighter, so I'm adding some white in. I didn't have much more space for the double leaves, so I added some single ones in there. And don't forget, as you do the design, you can make them encroach off the side as if the whole pattern has just been cut away. You can paint right over onto the underside if you wish, but I just painted up to the lip and on the edge. The design is fairly full now, but I have some small spaces where I can add some small little details, and this just gives some contrast to the piece. I've gone and put my thumb in the blue paint there, but don't worry if you do make a smudge. If you have acrylic paint down first and you accidentally smudge acrylic paint over this, I just add a little bit of water and wipe it off. Or you can just take a wet wipe or a wet piece of cloth and wipe it away before it's dried. I'm very almost done with the painting now, so I'm going to set it aside and let that acrylic paint completely dry overnight. My acrylic paint is dried overnight now, and I'm going in with a varnish. I have other videos where I show you lots of different varnishes, because that's a whole nother video in itself. So I recommend finding a varnish that you love and working with that one and using that one. If you wondered how the underside turned out, when the first coat of acrylic paint dried, I decided to paint that disc at the bottom in a different colour, and I had a couple of smudge marks underneath, so I turned those into a couple of little flowers. So there's always an opportunity if you do make a mistake or an error, turn it into something else beautiful. Nothing ever has to be perfect, and I just want you to enjoy the projects and be creative and explore the possibilities. I have so many projects over here on YouTube to get you into your creativity, so please do take a look. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.